I'll turn the house and carry me away by the man of the shop. The old woman was there, and every time I asked her a question, she didn't know. Tell me, man, says I, do you know him? And I pointed out over the Atlantic Ocean to the Blasket Islands lying up there in the bay. Tell me, man, says I, but could you know the names of those three islands over there? Oh, I couldn't tell you, sir, she said, for they weren't there when I was going to bed last night.
Nothing he could do could seem to entice her back.
We felt sorry for him, but in the end, they grew exasperated. Jesus, they said, if they feel so bad, why not do what Hemingway did, Brendan, they said. Why not lift the revolver and just do it? But he couldn't, he said. Because Ernest Hemingway didn't believe in the hereafter. The hereafter, he said. Yeah, Father, man. That's what Brendan said. The hereafter. But I wasn't so sure. Those were his very words, Father, man. I wasn't so sure. Why do Catholics cross themselves three times? The forehead is crossed so that the Word of God may be in our thoughts and purify our minds. We cross our lips so that our speech may be holy and incline us to share the gospel with others. Now, cross your lips, because I want to share my gospel with you. Look towards the windows, my child. See the true story. The parable of Brendan Behan. Whatever else he was, Behan was God-branded. I don't know how else to put it. Among other odors, that of sanctity was predominant. That day before I signed him up for Hutchinson's publishers, it might have been Coleridge's Madam who was talking to me. God granted. That's how I found him. That's all I really have to say.
Either now or then.
So let us remember that as we pray. Amen. You see? see them all over there in the corner, Brendan, there. Look over there. They're all there with John Ryan, Trolley Travellers, Des McNamara, Bloody Hen, looking at Pig's Eye O'Donnell. Up here, the till is always going to be full, and the pumps and McDades and the Bailey man alive, you've got to see it. It's the same as the catacombs, only like I'm saying, the door to the back room, it won't ever close.
That's Jesus, Captain. Oh, well, I can't, there's no sport left.
Jesus, when you look over there and see who's coming to talk to us now.
Four fucking noobs.
I'll be out back in a minute, don't leave me out of your wish.
When I hear again, it's the first night of the Hostage by Brendan Behan. And if it's anything like it was last night, yes, and the night before that, and before that again, there are going to be some sore heads in the morning, fellas.
I remember, in September, when the winter storms were gone, and the shells of grain and the sun, and the boils of the table around the old house alarm of the living, there were impossible things. When all the days they were alone, all the captain and the kid, and all the dead to alone, and the captain and the
kid. I feel for me, fellows. This latest new development in your truly remarkable, really quite incomparable.
Whatever about that, Mr. Toilinsmore, it's a great day, surely, what I have made for him.
Well, like the other night in the job he said to me beyond the Wakefield, it's something that happens to them that's better than you.
Well, in what respect were they better than you, Brendan?
Well, Mr. Toilin, as England's premier literary critic, Louis would suggest that you ought to know it, for it was you who wrote this. It seems to be Ireland's function every 20 years or so to provide a playwright who will kick English drama from the past into the present. Mr. Behan may well fill the place of the king by showcasing.
Is that happening, sir?
Yeah, maybe this is what I always say. There is something so pure and crystalline about his mind at its best that none who came before, and probably not very many after, can be justified and said to have rivaled its tenderness and authenticity. Well, Brandon, I would have to say, Mr. Gap, one moment, please, if you will.
For weeks it was nothing but simony and sacrilege, and the sins crying to heaven for vengeance, and the big green catechism in our hands. Up here, with you and I, there will never again be disputes of any kind.
That Jesus don't embarrass me. Whether you're a great big woman and farmer, whether you happen to be in the city or anywhere else.
Jesus, look over there, devil there and his buddy Nikita cruising.
Hey! He was coming now. I feel like I've died and gone to heaven.
You have?
Hey, Salud, surely you can't be serious.
That, I'm afraid, is where you are wrong. I'm very much serious.